Hello friends. In this video, we will once again talk about one of the most convenient and underrated features of Home Assistant, packages. If you have already tried creating automations, scripts, and various helpers through the interface, you have probably noticed that over time everything becomes quite cumbersome. Objects are scattered across different sections, and it can be difficult to figure out what belongs to what. Packages solve this problem. With their help, you can gather all the logic of a specific smart home solution in a single file. Automations, sensors, scripts, input data, everything is together. And most importantly, this approach opens up more opportunities for scaling and sharing ready-made projects. Today I will show what a package is in Home Assistant, why this tool is more convenient than working only through the UI, and how to use it in practice according to the principle, one case, one package. More details are in my video. And meanwhile, as is tradition, I ask you to leave a like. This will help other people who are interested in the smart home topic find it. And of course, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that yet. So, let's figure out what a package is in Home Assistant. Essentially, it is a special way of organizing configuration where all objects related to a single smart home solution are collected in one YAML file. Such a file can include automations, scripts, sensors, templates, input data, for example, input underscore boolean, input underscore select, input underscore datetime, as well as any other logic needed for a specific case. That is, a package is a complete project in the form of a single file. Everything related to one task, whether it's an alarm clock, lighting control, or a battery charging scenario, is located in one place. As an example, my previous lesson about a smart alarm clock. In one package, we store the selectors for choosing time, the automation that starts it, and the script that plays the melody. All of this is in one file, instead of being scattered across different sections of the interface. Now let's figure out why we should use packages at all. The main idea is order and convenience. When we have dozens of automations, scripts, and sensors, it's very easy to get lost. Packages allow you to collect everything related to a specific solution in one file. What advantages does this provide? Centralization. The entire project is stored in one place. You don't need to search for automations in one section, scripts in another, and helper variables somewhere else. Everything lies together. Scalability. If you are developing a smart home, the number of scenarios constantly grows. Packages help maintain order and easily add new cases. Reusability. It is very convenient to share your packages. It's enough to copy a single YAML file, and the whole project will work for another user. Documentation. The package itself can be considered a description of the project. From the file, you can immediately see how the logic is built, which entities are used, and how they are connected to each other. Thus, packages make Home Assistant more structured and manageable. This is a tool especially valued by those who not only work for themselves, but also want to share ready-made solutions with others. Now let's compare the approach via packages with the usual creation of objects in the Home Assistant interface. When we work through the UI, everything is fragmented. Automations live in the automations section. Scripts. In scripts, helper entities like input underscore boolean or input underscore select are located in helpers. And all this is not connected into a single picture. If the project is complex, you have to remember which elements belong to which task. The drawbacks of this approach are obvious. It's hard to tie the logic into a single whole. It's difficult to share ready-made solutions. At most, you can export individual automations. As you scale, confusion appears. With packages, it's different. The entire project, with all dependencies and logic, is stored in a single file. Such a file can be put in Git, sent to a friend, or simply transferred to another Home Assistant. It turns out that the UI is well suited for quick experiments, while packages are a tool for a systematic approach and full-fledged smart home design. Let's enable package support and immediately set up a convenient project structure. Open configuration.yaml and add the packages section inside the Home Assistant block. I recommend storing all packages in a separate folder to make projects easier to scale. We use the include underscore dir underscore merge underscore name directive, which merges all files into a single dictionary by names. An important point, packages must be located exactly inside Home Assistant, at the correct indentation level. If you put it in the wrong place, Home Assistant simply won't pick up the packages. Let's create an includes folder at the root of the Home Assistant configuration. All files and subfolders inside includes will be automatically recognized as packages. This is very convenient. You can group cases by rooms or by types of solutions. For example, like this. Each .yaml here is a complete package in which you can describe everything related to one case. Automation, script, input, sensor, etc. After adding package support, we check the configuration in the menu Developer Tools, YAML, Check Configuration. If everything is done correctly, you will see this message. After that, we restart Home Assistant. One more clarification, objects, automations, and scripts created before this, manually or through the interface, will work fine even after enabling package support. All these configuration methods do not interfere with each other, which allows for a smooth migration. As an example, let's look at a package from my previous video, which describes all the logic of the alarm clock. Note, the top-level key is a unique name of the package within the general dictionary. Inside it lie the usual sections that declare various Home Assistant integrations. After adding packages, we check the configuration, Developer Tools, YAML, Check Configuration. In most cases, there is no need to restart the whole system, unless you have declared new integrations that were not used before. For ordinary changes, it is enough to reload only the necessary sections, automations, scripts, template entities. A few useful tips. YAML is sensitive to indentation. Be sure to follow the nesting order. The package name has zero indentation. Then all sections at the first level of nesting, and the objects created by these sections are nested within them, and so on. Try to make each package self-sufficient. Everything related to the case lies in one file. If you have common constants or tokens, store them in secrets.yaml and refer to them in packages via secret. Name packages and files so that the name makes it clear what's inside. If you see name conflicts or duplicate entities, check whether they are also defined somewhere outside the package. That's it. Now Home Assistant will automatically collect all packages from the includes folder, and you will be able to scale the project according to the one case, one package principle, maintaining perfect order. Now the main thing is how to think in packages. The principle is simple. One completed smart home case equals one package. A case is a solution with a clear goal and boundaries. For example, an alarm clock in the bedroom, night lighting in the kitchen, controlling a boiler by tariffs, training an EcoFlow battery. Why do this? So that each package is autonomous, easily transferable, and does not pull hidden dependencies with it. So that by the file name you can immediately understand its purpose. So that the project scales without chaos. Inside each package is everything needed for the case. Input, automation, script, sensor, etc. Ideally, a package should not require external entities, except for explicitly specified ones. Naming rules, very important for a large project. Package prefix and entity names, alarm, night, battery. This speeds up search and eliminates conflicts. Clear aliases. The alias should make it obvious what and when. For example, alarm, start by time. Night light, motion sensor. Do not use the same entity name in different packages. Checklist before adding slash publishing a package. Self-sufficiency. Everything needed for the case is declared inside the package. Names, unique and with a meaningful prefix. Secrets, tokens, passwords, paths, through, secret. Configuration check, then restart of integrations or the core. Documentation, at the top of the package leave a short block of comments, purpose, inputs slash outputs, dependencies. How to split cases. I use a folder structure named after rooms, or by task direction if the cases described in them are not related to a specific room. Inside the folders, package files, which are named according to the case described in them. This makes it quick to find the right one, both for making changes and for using it as a template for a similar case. Migration from UI to packages. Export an existing automation from the UI into YAML and transfer it into the required package. Create input, template, script right next to it, in the same file. Temporarily leave the old version disabled, test the packaged one. Once you are sure it works, delete slash disable the duplicates from the UI. Result, the principle one case, one package, turns your smart home into a set of modular bricks. A new task appears, create a new package. Need to share a solution, send one file. Order, control, and scaling speed, that's what you get. As a practical example, a package from another one of my videos about the use of thermostatic valves. You can find the link to it in the description under the video, so I won't go into detail, I will just show the main blocks. I will also note, I use 5 such packages, one I wrote from scratch, the rest were scaled using a simple copy-paste and auto-replace. This process takes less than 1 minute, which is completely impossible when using the GUI. The first line, with zero indentation, is the unique name of this package. All other sections must be nested inside it. A package can include almost everything, including recorder. I have enabled the setting, not to save anything except what is explicitly specified. This greatly saves the database size, and thanks to packages, it is very convenient to define right here what I want to store, in this case, the thermostat itself. Next comes the Home Assistant section, similar to the one declared in configuration.yaml. Already inside it, I declare the customization section, in which I assign a friendly name to certain objects. This is much more convenient, clearer, and faster than in the interface, going into each one separately, and when scaling the package, everything is done with just a few auto replacements. Next, the following integration is declared, MQTT, in which an object is described, a binary sensor, also related to this case. Next in this package comes the switch section, in which a logical switch is described, then a template with the description of another binary sensor. The sequence of sections does not matter, the order can be any. The main thing is that it is convenient and clear to you personally. Then comes the logic. In this case, it is one script and several automations. For another thermostatic valve, it is enough to create a new file, copy and paste this code into it, and then make a few auto replacements, object names, prefixes, and titles. As I said earlier, this takes about a minute, a result absolutely unattainable when using the interface. Everything needed to implement this case, or in other words, one of the logical blocks that make up the smart home, is gathered in one file. This approach clearly shows how convenient it is to work by the principle one case, one package. Main advantages: all functionality is gathered in one place. The package is easy to transfer to another Home Assistant or share with the community. Configuration and debugging become faster. Everything is visible in one YAML file. Scaling the project is easy. Need a new scenario? Create a new package. And most importantly, order. Even a year later, you will be able to quickly find how a function works, because it will have its own separate package. Use the principle one case, one package, and your smart home will be not only smart, but also well organized. That's all. I hope the video was interesting and useful for you. I will be grateful for your likes. They help with promotion on YouTube, and if you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the description under the video, I will leave links to all the mentioned tutorials, as well as to my Telegram channels and social networks, groups for communication on smart home topics. Join in, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time. Peace to all.